So now we will see input attribute form ENC type in input field. So guys, basically the input form ENC type attribute specifies how the form data should be encoded when submitted, and it is only applicable when the forms are with the method is equal to post value. So guys, basically over here ENC stands for encoding, and what type of encoding is done when the data is being submitted by the form with the method post is defined by the form ENC type over here. It is very important to note that this attribute overrides the ENC type attribute of the form element. So by default we have certain value that is assigned to the ENC type attribute which will be overridden by this form ENC type attribute, and this particular attribute works with the following input types, that is submit and image. So guys, basically the submit button or the image button that we have inside the form, in order to submit the form data, will have the attribute that is form ENC type, for which we will have certain value. So guys, let us check this with the help of examples in VS code over here. So basically I'll remove previous lines of code that we had written, and we will only keep the paragraph that is below content is in HTML form. So guys, now we will define the form with the post request over here. So we have the method with the post value, and then inside the form what we will do is we will have the field with the first name. So we will define the input with the type text over here, and then we will have the name attribute as fname in this case, and the same value we will paste it inside the id attribute as well. And before this we will also have the label that is having the for attribute as fname, and then we will say first name in this case followed by colon. So guys, we have a single field over here, after which we are going to have couple of line breaks in this case. Now guys, simply we will have the submit button over here. So input colon submit in this case, and we will keep the value as submit so that this particular value is displayed on the submit button. So guys, let me just save this file now and try reloading this page on the browser. So as you can see, we have the first name label, and then simply we can provide the first name inside this input field. And since the method is of the post value over here inside the form, we won't be able to see the parameters being passed as the part of URL when we click on submit. So guys, when we click on submit in this case, there is no change in the URL that is happening, but the value is going to the server based on the post method over here. But guys, currently the encoding type of the data that is going to the server is the default value. What if we want the data to be encoded in a different way? So what we can do is inside the submit button, we can have the form ENC type over here. So as you can see, this is the attribute that we can use in this case, and it has three values. So by default it is text slash plain data that is being passed to the server, and we can also select multipart slash form data over here. So if we select this, so basically this will be the encoding that will be done to this particular data that is being sent to the server. So guys, currently we won't be able to see any change, but when we are going to learn about the server side scripting and handling the data that is coming from the client side, over there we will be seeing the difference between the various values of the form ENC type attribute over here. So let me just save this file now and try reloading this page once again on the browser. So now if we provide some data over here, so let's say I provide the first name as John and click on submit button. So basically the data is getting encoded with the help of this particular value, and it is passed to the server. So guys, in this way you can easily provide the value to the form ENC type, and based on your requirements you can select one of the values of this particular attribute and handle the data accordingly that is being passed to the server. Comment in the comment section below whether you have learned something out of this video. Please make sure that you like this video so that it reaches to more people, and subscribe to this channel so that you get the notifications on upcoming videos as well. The next video that we are going to talk about is input attribute form method in input field. So stay tuned.